first round on me, and all beef get deceased tonight. No fights, all hype, let the Buddah Ratt grab the mic.
All the music in the air, lots of love and
better give me the mic and let me show you how it needs to be done. I'ma keep the party popping till you sing in the sun.
Give me the mic.
I keep them girls backing it up, shaking their kitty, blowing sticky, put some yak in the door.
Give me the mic.
DJ, put the record back on. Let the blinkers and the pimps and the house back.
Give me the mic.
Put my folk that screen. Where the dollar at? Throw it up.
Hey, what's up, Uncle Buddha's neighborhood? It's your man, Uncle Buddha, right here, and I'm hanging out with one of the greatest friends of all times. I love this lady right here.
I love you back.
My girl, Sue Ham, baby. That's what I call her. But now you're Salandia Hammond.
Oh, man, dude, I was always Salandia Hammond, but I'm going to always be Sue Ham, baby, to you.
I know. But that's awesome, though, that I got to see that transformation kind of like.
Yeah.
That's like... Your maturity in the game. You know what I'm saying? Like, you watch me grow, and I watch you grow. How did we even
meet? You helped me grow.
Yeah.
We
helped each other. How did we even meet?
Buddha, I'm going to be honest with you. I really have no idea.
I thought about that before the interview. I was like, I got to find me and Sue Ham.
You know what I think it was?
I don't remember.
I was doing a kid's talent show, the Sue Ham Kids Talent Show, and I was advertising spots on a station that you worked at.
Okay.
And then... I think you were like, come on in, let's meet. And at the time, you were playing music from Huey B from King Street, South Carolina.
Oh, yeah, yep, Huey B, that's my man.
Yeah, and so somehow or another, I don't know, the 6 degrees of separation, it went off like that.
Man, we've been kicking it ever since.
Yes.
And they used to come to all my shows and dance on the stage and do the Michael Jackson, everybody loved it. I was like, this woman is crazy. But
really?
We started hanging out, we started kicking it, we became good friends. And you are doing so much positive stuff right now. I mean, you went from doing the Michael Jackson on stage, making people laugh, to now you're like the female Tyler Perry of South Carolina right now.
Cut it out,
I'm telling
dude.
You.
Cut it out.
Really, though. Like, that's where I see you. That's where I picture you going.
Wow. Thank you, man.
No, for real. Because, wow. You know, when I see you and I listen to you talk and you talk about your dreams and what you want to achieve, I've been following you, and I see that everything is falling right in line. From you wanting to do stage plays, to owning your own building, to having this, all that stuff is falling in line, right?
It's about consistency, man, mm-hmm. and just writing out your plans and following it through. But it is happening, and I thank you for that, you know. But yeah, because just starting out, it was just like, man, this is not going to happen. This, mm-hmm. It was like so many setbacks and whatnot, but then it's just like, yo, this is what I really want. Mm-hmm. I mean, if I'm not going to do this, I'm just going to waste my life. So let me just get busy about staying consistent and making these things fall into place, because... One thing for me is watching people like you just keep climbing the ladder. And this is just for real. Like, even with your Stop the Violence movement, man, how you're just taking this on and you're going around from city to city here in South Carolina. And I just got word that you're going to be moving out to Charlotte and doing a big event there. That's just amazing to me how you use your platform for good, you know. And so you inspire me. How can I stop?
Well, that's awesome to know.
I got Uncle Buddha Ratt's
and
tracks
that's awesome
I'm following
to know. You know what I'm saying? That's awesome to know, because you inspire a lot of people that I'm around too. I mean, a lot of people that I'm around, when they first meet you, next thing you know, they're following you and stuff like that. How has social media helped you?
Oh my God, social media is like the ram in the bush, man.
Yeah.
It's crazy. Look, you got social media. So many people are like, social media is the devil, it's bad. Nah, social media is a platform. It's like a car. It's like a gun.
Use it for what it's right.
It's not bad. It's the people who use it that are bad.
Right.
So for me, I use it for all things good, promoting positivity, promoting my brand, promoting other people that I see are very, very talented that I want to help them get a leg up. So social media has been amazing. It's helped me to land national TV roles. It's helped me to expand my brand, influence other people. And just go into countries I can't physically be in, but because of the internet, Facebook, LinkedIn,
that's
YouTube,
right.
Twitter,
that's true.
Instagram.
You can be anywhere.
I can be anywhere.
That's right. So, all right, well, I'll tell you what, we're going to take a break. When we return,
cool.
That's another thing I want to talk about,
right.
too. You expanding your brand. Hey, Uncle Buddha's Neighborhood. We live with my girl, Sue Ham, baby. Y'all stay tuned.
I just need everybody to join me on a dance floor. You know, get her too. You know, grab a friend, grab a partner, grab a lover. It don't matter. Hey. Okay, let's try this out. Let's do this.
Tell me that you love me right in front of me. Girl, I got your back, so don't you front on me. Baby, turn around, do that dance for me. Lie to the judge, only stand for me. Tell me that you love me right in front of me. Girl, I got your back, so don't you front on me. Baby, turn around, do that dance for me. Lie to the judge, only stand for me. Show me that you love me.
Show me that it's home, man. Show me that you love me. Love me for a long time. Looking at your body, girl, I think you got me hypnotized. The way you uncoil your
life. Hey, Uncle Buddah's Neighborhood. I'm hanging out with my girl, good friend of mine, Sue Ham, Solania Hammond.
Dude, you got it right, too.
Let's talk about the brand. That's right. You got to get it right. So what made you, what was the point in your life that just made you say, you know, I got to turn everything around? Because it seems like you just went from here to there. You know, what made you just say, I got to go to another level with this?
Because I was going for rich. A lot of people say I like to go for broke. No, I've been there. I don't like that. I was going for rich. And at the point, I was at the lowest point in my life where, like, I had lost all my material possessions. And it was just like, okay, now my kids are watching me. Here I am talking about, you can have your dreams. You know, it's worth following it. And I was like, yo, I cannot be a liar to my children, first and foremost, to myself either. And so because I had lost all my money, my cars, my rental houses and everything like that, my back was against the wall. It was like, yo, what else do I have to lose? My dignity by not following my dreams? So I made a conscious effort. That's the first thing. Make a decision to do the things I needed to do to live my dreams. That's the second thing. Take consistent action. And I just started going hard, man. I started picking up my picture camera phone. That's what I call it. Most of y'all call it the cell phone, the iPhone. But I picked up my picture camera phone and I said, you know what? I'm going to start videoing stuff. I'm going to put out positive message. I'm going to put out comical message, inspirational message, business messages, and just start doing this thing. And I'm just going to raise money and start doing my own shows, because at the time I couldn't find investors. And I was like, who can be the best investor? And I was like, me. If I believe in myself, if I want people to help me, I got to show them that I believe enough in myself to help myself. Sure. And because of that, you know, it started attracting people like you. You would pick up the phone or text me and be like, yo, Sue, you want to come and talk about your show? And I'm like, oh, my God. People I didn't know, they're like, you want to come talk about your show? We see what you're doing. So, you know, it was just at my lowest that I made that decision that I'm going to go for it. And I just stayed the course, and it started attracting other people to.
People like Steve Harvey started knocking. I was like, Sue Ham's on Steve Harvey. Oh, turn on the TV, baby. How'd that happen?
Again, my videos, man. Just doing videos from my phone, putting them out there in social media and whatnot. And then I was sitting at the house, and I was like, I want to be on Steve Harvey's show. Because, you know, I have been envisioning this for years.
Yeah, I know.
But here's the thing, though, Buddha. You can see stuff happening, but if you ain't doing nothing, right? Mm-hmm. You wasting your time. So I was like, well, let me go to his website. Again, the internet. So I go to the website and it says, be a guest on Steve Harvey's show. And I was like, okay. So I clicked on it, man. And I sent my videos and the producers called me. And it was just like, I didn't get on initially, right?
That's awesome.
Because they had to go through three producers. So two of the producers shot it down. So I was like, okay, well, I'm going to keep sending y'all my videos anyway. And I did. And 2 years later, I got on the show. 2 months later, they called me back to get on the show again.
Wow.
So, again, that's why I harp on consistency, man, and just really going through what's in your gut. So
how hard is that, getting a door closed and slammed in your face? You know, somebody saying, oh, we don't want you for this, or we don't need you for that, or no, we can't use you this time.
Dude, it's extremely hard.
Those are things
in the beginning.
Right.
It's extremely hard. But matter of fact, let me share this with you just this week, all right? First of all, it's extremely hard getting the door shut in your face. But after a while, you get used to it. You build thick skin. Because when you believe that you're built for this, right, nothing's going to stop you anyways. So, but just this week, I submitted to a writing contest. And then they came back, and it's a major writing contest. They came back and said, we like your story. We like your script. Let's move forward. And come to find out, it was a freaking scam.
Oh, wow.
It was a freaking scam. And I was just like, wow. Because I was already sitting there like, yeah, it's happening. I'm going to go ahead and make this film.
Right.
But it came back as a scam. So that was a major rejection.
Disappointment, too.
Yeah, it was a disappointment. And it's sad that people prey on other people's feelings. And I just said to myself, hey, no big deal. Just because they said no, or it was a rejection or a disappointment, that doesn't mean that, you know, the buck stops.
Right.
I got to keep going. The gift still lives in me. So it's up to me. I really believe this. It's up to me to make my dreams a reality.
And how do you come up, like the stage play? Let's talk about that.
Uh-huh.
Well, matter of fact, let's take a break real quick.
Okay.
And then we come back. I want to talk about your writing and the plays that you're doing and things like that. Because I went to, you know, I was at your last one.
Yeah.
It was amazing. It was
Thank you, man. Thank you, crazy.
And I forgot where I was at. I thought I was like on Broadway somewhere. You know what I mean? So when we come back, we're going to talk about Sue Ham and her plays, man. The stage plays are awesome. Uncle Buddha's Neighborhood. I'm hanging out with Sue Ham. More when I return. What's up, y'all? It's Uncle Buddah hanging out at the iHeartRadio studios. And if you haven't subscribed to our YouTube page, make sure you do that ASAP. Uncle Buddha's Neighborhood, all right?